It's great to be here in Christchurch. I'm here to participate in the Christchurch Conversations Thursday evening. I'm going to talk about a project that I did back at home in Atlanta in the United States, repurposing a loop of old railroads for a new transit line and greenway trail and parks and community revitalization. It started as my graduate school project, but now we're building it. It's having a huge impact on the life of the city, changing both the physical form of the city, but also the way that people think about the city, what their expectations are for their city. It's a completely, really transformational project. So I'm going to share that, a book that I wrote about a year ago that connects it to other projects happening around the world. Basically, the idea is that repurposing old infrastructure and public space to achieve a different kind of life for a city. You've got a really fascinating sort of situation where you've got all this land, that rebuilding the city and the public space is really a reflection of who you are as a city. And so now with all the reconstruction, you're really redefining what the city is. And so there's, if you're thoughtful about that, you can make sure that it's sort of refreshed and a modern sort of view for the city. And I don't know, it's just an interesting time to be here. I'm interested to learn a lot about what you're doing. Sure, well, I became fascinated with the other projects around the world as our project gained momentum. It got some attraction from other cities, so I'd go there to share our story, and always learning that every city I went to, there was something else similar happening. So the High Line in New York is a great example, but very small, but huge impact, similar kind of grassroots movement. The Los Angeles River is a different kind of thing, 50-mile-long concrete river being transformed into something completely new for the city of Los Angeles, and redefining not only the city itself, but who it is and who lives there and why, and the decisions that people make about living. There's a project in Singapore called the Rail Corridor, in Seoul, the Chiang Kai-shek, in Paris, the Petit Ceinture. These projects are everywhere, where people are reclaiming usually obsolete or underutilized urban land and infrastructure and reclaiming some new kind of life for themselves. And it's interesting to see they've all kind of emerged in the last 10 or 15 years. So I think it means something and it matters to how we live. And we don't really know where it's going, but it's fun to be a part of it. I just got in late last night and we're standing in the red zone. And I know that for people here who live here, there must be a lot of emotion around that, and I understand that, but also it's quite beautiful and certainly presents a pretty amazing opportunity for the city to think carefully about what you're doing, of course, which I know you are, but also understand that whatever you do is a reflection of who you are as a city and what you want to be. And so it's a physical kind of representation of an aspiration for the city, and it's important really to be thoughtful about that and who this is for, and how the things that you do here reflect the people who were here and the future population of the city.